Bishops from around the world ended their three-day sex abuse summit with a penitential mass, praying for forgiveness for crimes committed and covered up for years. And though there have been efforts at reform before, those in attendance this time guarantee change.
No se puede escapar de lo que sucede, pero se debe soportar, no importa lo feo que sea. Ningún día sin recuerdos, ningún día sin flashbacks.
With a victim survivor playing his pain at a mass of penance inside the Vatican, the sun is setting on Rome outside as the Protection of Minors Summit seeks to wipe out the darkness that has haunted the church for decades, sex abuse.
Puedo impedir que esto suceda aprendiendo a controlarlo y aprendiendo a hablar de ello.
We can face that bishops, priests, deacons, and religious in the church have done violence to children and youth, and that we have failed to protect those who most needed our care.
You have betrayed the priesthood.
Protesters from the US, India, Africa, Canada, and the Philippines have kept a close eye on the Vatican this week. After 3 days and dozens of proposals for change in what the Holy Father calls a concrete plan, victims say only mandatory reporting is acceptable.
They are undermining us.
Pennsylvania State Representative Mark Rossi, a child sex abuse victim of a priest, says through his trauma, he's devoted to changing the church he still loves.
I know exactly what's going on, that they truly aren't meaning what they're saying, because if they did, they would stand behind us, and Pope Francis would tell his bishops to stand down, stop blocking victims from going into a civil court of law and receiving not only justice, but the truth about how and why.
Zero tolerance for abuse and cover-ups, victim survivors supported each other at Piazza del Popolo.
Before those who should pass judgment actually...
Other survivors echoed those sentiments standing before bishops at the meeting. A young woman left them speechless and driven to save others. In describing the priest who overpowered her with his strength, she said she never forgets. These thoughts are the worst wounds that the abuse and the abuser insinuates into your heart, more than the wounds that lacerate your body. I just wanted to die. I tried. There are also those who tried and did not make it.
Listening to the narrative of victims is essential as a motivation for getting it right.
Urging church leaders to hear their pleas, but more importantly, put words of apology into action. Cardinal Reinhard Marx offered a step-by-step guide today.
Public announcement of statistics on the number of cases and details thereof, files that could have documented the terrible deeds and named those responsible, were destroyed or not even created. Establishing transparent procedural norms and rules for ecclesiastical processes is essential.
The worldwide crisis taking center stage in Rome has often been considered an American problem. Intense discussion brought bishops to the realization children have suffered globally. But there will be no specific rules mandated for handling sex abuse cases.
There will be as well norms issued by Vatican City State, which we can look at to see whether or not we're in conformity with those. And then bishops' conferences will have to go back home and deal with the issue of how they're going to hold each other accountable.
For those who spent their lives trying to shed the anguish of their abuse, the discussion alone offers hope for the future.
I was abused as a girl. I'm transgender. And so it's been an interesting journey for me. It's very isolating to grow up in this culture of repression and secrecy, but to be here among other people, to be out about talking about our experiences and comforting each other, I mean, that's just life-changing.
The chapter on sex abuse in the church does not end with this summit. After a mass tomorrow with the Holy Father, efforts for reform head to the home countries of those in attendance. And they say they are asking for everyone to accompany them in prayer and get involved with the change. At the Vatican, Dina Baer, WGN News.